Hi Norbert here, and showing in the video of the series number 34 a few appliances that work on the 12 volt of a car battery. Please look first to the other videos of this series to know the how and the why of this simple system that costed in Italy $250. The main idea here is to get a reliable power supply from an unreliable grid. And this problem is not only for the developing countries. The amount of blackouts in the United States became double from 2003 to now, and it became one of the most unreliable grids among those of
developed countries.
Now, the system which I propose is very simple and also very robust. I even kept out the inverter, so that means the high voltage AC. To start simple, but you can always add it afterwards. So that means today we will look to a few household appliances which are available on the market. If you like the idea of simple and reliable technology that can later be expanded, then please subscribe to the channel with a notification. So let's now look to these appliances. Okay, here's the battery, and here's the fuse, as we saw the other week. And if we switch this on, this is also the main switch. Then we see here the voltage. Let's now attach some appliances. So we look through this USB port and we start with the telephone. That's charging. Here is a lamp, you saw it from other videos. So we can put it in different modes. And you can charge it with USB. You see now the red light here. Let's now see some other devices which function on this socket. This is a very small vacuum cleaner. I hope yours is stronger. And then you can... So this is a cooker. No, it's not a cooker, but it's a heater of food. You put this on the side, you can close it, and then you have here the compartment where you put the fork and the knife. These two plugs are connected to this device. And I can try it now with this one. Okay. So now it has a red light here. You can see it. And it is heating now. Let's see now the application of the 12 volt battery. I took now the light one because it's just portable. And in combination with the 24 volt DC transformer, we try the LED strip, which we know it's at 24 volt. So we took these connections from this DC supply and we put it on the 24 volt output of this transformer from 12 volt to 24 volt. And now we are measuring the current and we look if it's let's see what happens. A little spark. And we see nearly 3 ampere. Yeah, it's now 3 ampere. And that means with the 12 volt we are at 36 volt, which the battery is now delivering. By the way, I tried it also directly on the battery, but that doesn't work. And now you'll try this inverter. You have here also USB ports, and you have here a switch. And now the green light is on. That means we have 230 volts. Okay, let's try something. So let's take care. This will spin very fast. Oh, it even works. 160 watt and it needs also an inrush current to start. But yes, it's working. Hello friends, so here's my promise to test this cool box to bring the temperature of 2 liter waters, let's say 10 degrees below the ambient temperature. So I saw that this is consuming 50 watts and I thought, well, 50 watts, that's more or less like the average consumption of a normal fridge for such a small cool box. But okay, it is working on Peltier elements, so that's not as efficient as a compressor. I have now 1 liter of water. That is the half of 2 liters, so I'm saving 50%. This is exactly 1 liter. So, there we are. Temperature sensor. Okay. I hope you like this video, and if you belong to the people that live today with great anxiety, you surely want to make this affordable step for reliable power. Please like and share the video, subscribe to the channel and put the notification. Write in the comments if you would like that I treat something about energy home in my next videos. I wish you good energy.